When you think about the topic of this year's EBS Symposium, adapting to change, the beginning of a new era, how does this relate to what you are doing at your company?
Yeah, so the beginning of a new era is indeed, I think, the right title. So for BCG, I think the last 18 months were actually, I would say, an accelerator of innovation and an accelerator of innovation into a new era in two dimensions. The first one is actually the type of work we do for our clients. So on the digital side, on the climate side, things accelerated massively and we are helping clients in a much broader sense. But secondly, and equally important, I think it was also the beginning of a new era in the way we work. So whereas in the past, we typically worked 4 days on the client side, 1 day in a BCG office, we are right now, and we will be in future work in a hybrid model. We call this next generation ways of working. And we think about this as a major upside, actually, going forward in terms of our ability to create value for our clients, but also offer flexibility to our people, to actually to many of the young people joining us. So they will have much more flexibility in terms of where to work from.
Okay, that sounds really interesting. But how does your company actually empower change, something like digitalization or diversity?
So we have many initiatives ongoing on, for example, diversity, as you mentioned it. I mean, we work very heavily towards increasing our female share, but also on the LGBTQ side. And the most important thing there is actually to create an inclusive environment so that everyone feels welcome. And this is important to me personally. It's important to the broader leadership, and I think it's also reflected in all our, I would say, internal processes. So that's on how we empower change on the diversity side. How do we empower change on the digital side? Look, I think the consultant today versus the consultant when I started, the very beginning of my career, is a very different thing, right? Today, the consultant is essentially, armed with many digital tools on the analytics side, but also on the sort of virtual interaction side. So on the analytics side, we work, for example, with tools such as Tableau, very sophisticated analytics tools and so on. And on the virtual interaction side, I mean, we all work with Zoom, with Teams, what have you today, right? Mm-hmm. This is a very different sort of, I would say, digital arsenal you had that compared to 15 years ago. So the consultant today, I think, is empowered, I would say, to work much more digital today, which I think is great, actually.
Okay, and how would you describe your leadership style and what values do you want to represent with it?
Oh, this is a good question. Look, for me, a couple of things are very, personally, very important. The first one is it's all about being ambitious in terms of how do you set a goal, right? I think as a team and so on, I think if you don't set yourself an ambitious target, I think you're never going to get there, right? Mm-hmm. So I think that's quite important. And that's, I think, a really important trait. The second one is actually, and I mentioned it already, you set yourself a target as a team. The second one is really, it's about teaming. So consulting and leadership in more general in the 20s is not about individuals anymore. It's about teams, actually. Yeah? So the world is too complicated to deal with them on your own. So you do need a strong team. So for me, it's really important that we lead BCG as a team in the partner group, but also in my inner leadership team, actually, and we work, we have sometimes constructive conflicts, we have intense discussions, but then we move forward. So that's the second thing, which is really important. And the third thing that is really important to me is also about, call it persistence. Huh? I mean, leadership, we always say it's a marathon and it's not a sprint. And indeed it is, right? You don't make a difference in a week, in a month, but you do make a difference in a couple of years. And that's also, by the way, the advice I would give to many, to my sort of former self, if I would look at me when I started at BCG, right? I think those three things hold true, right? I think big, be ambitious, right? Secondly, don't do it alone, do it in a team. You're much more likely to be successful, right? And frankly, it's much more fun, right? And lastly, think about this as a marathon, right? Don't think about it as a sprint. It's okay if there is not immediate results there after 6 months. If you need to wait for 12 months, 24 months, it's okay if there is a backlash, right, at some point. That's natural, right? But ultimately, if you stay on it and so on, I think you're very likely to succeed.
Yeah, it's great that you mentioned teams especially, because I think we're experiencing things like this at the moment as we're working together here to organize this event. And we realize one day after another, it's not working when you can acquire speakers or acquire some event sponsors, but the event is not gonna get that nice if you're not working together. Yeah. Okay, but you also mentioned the younger generation. So what advice would you give our participants, our young ambitious students, to follow their life and their career? What values would you give them? What is important in the business world?
Well, first I can come back to sort of my own leadership principles and my advice to my former self, right? I think be ambitious, think about it in a team and stay on it. I think that holds true, I think for everyone, right? And I think that would be sort of clearly part one of my advice to everyone here. Part two of my advice is, frankly, also, yeah, I mean, hey, you spend so much time at work, right? Do something you're absolutely passionate about, right? And I think consulting, I think, is a great place, to find that, because frankly, when you join us, you have many, many things to choose from. You can choose from basically every industry. You can choose from many different topics to work from, and you can test where you have your passion, whether your passion is in serving healthcare clients or industrial clients, whether your passion is more on working on digital topics or on, I would say, hands-on operational improvement. Maybe you don't know by now, right? But by sort of doing it hands-on, you will know, right? You can find out. And then you can sort of make a career choice based, I would say, on much more data. And I think consulting is actually a great, at least start into a successful career at the end of the day.
Nice. Okay, then Matthias, let's come to the EBS Symposium itself. You've been part of it several times now. What do you associate with the EBS Symposium in general?
Well, I'm looking forward to getting to know many of the participants. I think I always look at this. Look, this is the future. You guys are the future of BCG, but of many companies out there. And to me, it's a window into the future. And hence, I'm looking forward to getting to know many young colleagues, learn from them, and learn about the future in that.
Yeah, it's great to have you as a speaker, but also your company BCG is going to hold a workshop, and maybe you will have some new interns in next summer. Okay, but lastly, what do you expect from this year's EBS Symposium?
So I think the headline this year is, you mentioned it before, right? It's a new era. So I'm looking forward to learn a lot about how others tackle the new era, how others tackle sort of the accelerated innovation which comes with that. And I think it's a point in time where we all need to learn from different parts, because uncertainty has gone up. I think the more you know, the better you will deal with it. And so I'm looking forward to learn. I'm looking forward to learn about how others tackle the new era and how others innovate in that period of time.
All right. Thank you so much, Matthias, for taking your time to listen to our questions. And you will not get disappointed in September.
Great. Thank you so much.